ChargeLab previously took apart the Meta Quest tooling cable, and recently Meta released the Quest 3 VR headset. Unfortunately, we haven't got it yet, but we do have a 45W PD charger for the older Meta Quest Pro. This charger can not only charge the Meta Quest Pro, but also mobile phones, laptops, and other devices. Remove the plastic film. It adopts a simple white design with an oval shape and a glossy surface. The input prongs cannot be folded, and the specs info are printed under the prongs. Model is AN45A-59CF-KCV. It can support input of 100-240V, 50 or 60Hz, 1A. The output power can be up to 20V, 2.25A, 45W. The manufacturer is Feihong. There is a new logo of Meta below the specs info. The USB-C port is at the bottom of the charger. And the size of this charger is about 63x42x28mm. The weight of it is about 96 grams. ChargeLab Power ZKM003C shows it can support PD 3.0, PPS, QC4, and DCP charging protocols. It also has 4 fixed speeds of 5V, 9V, 15V, 3A, 20V, 2.25A, and 2 sets of PPS. Next, continue to take it apart. Use a spider to pry the upper cover off. The PCBA module is filled with potting compound to enhance heat dissipation. Then use a small cutting machine to destroy the outer case. And take out the entire PCBA module. The gaps between components are filled with potting compound for fixing. Clean up the PCBA module. There are fuse, common mode choke, electricity capacitor, transformer, solid capacitor, and USB-C connector on the front. These two most obvious chips on the back are the bridge rectifier and the power IC. The exposed copper trace can facilitate heat dissipation of the power IC. ChargeLab found that it adopts flyback topology and synchronous rectification for output. The input fuse is from water fuse, 3.15 amp, 250 volts. The common mode choke is wound with magnet and insulated wires. The safety X2 capacitor is from HJC, 0.1 microfarad. The bridge rectifier is from Liton, 1000 volts, 8 amp. One of the electrolytic capacitors for input filtering is from Ferrotronic FZE series, 400 volts, 27 microfarad. The other two are from Anshi, which are 400 volts, 27 microfarad. So the total capacity is 81 microfarad. The differential mode choke is wound with an I-shaped magnetic core. The highly integrated power IC is from Power Integrations, which can be regarded as MOST control chip. It also integrates MOSFET and synchronous rectifier controller, which can simplify the circuit design. Except for that, it supports voltage feedback function to replace the missing optocoupler. The electricity capacitor that powers the MES control chip is 100 volts, 4.7 microfarad. The transformer is wrapped in tape for insulation. Here is the blue-white capacitor. The synchronous rectifier is from AOS and adopts DFN 5x6 package. 100 volts, 6.3 milliohm. These two solid capacitors for output filtering are from Polycap RT series, 470 microfarad, 25 volts. The protocol chip is from Wellchand. It supports USB PD 3.0, QC4, and QC4+. It has a built-in 8-bit MCU and temperature sensor. The output VBUS MOSFET is from Exilience MOS and adopts EDFN 3x3 package. 30 volts, 4 milliohm. The USB-C connector is soldered on the reinforced vertical PCB. Well, those are all the components of this charger. It adopts a simple oval design, except for charging the MetaQuest Pro. It can also meet the charging needs of most phones and laptops. After taking apart, the PCBA is filled with poly compound to enhance heat dissipation. The highly integrated Power IC from Power Integrations has many built-in components. It can improve space utilization, simplify the circuit, and reduce the size of this charger. Its solid quality can provide a stable power supply to the MetaQuest Pro and other devices. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you next time. Bye!